everyone. So today is day four of our matter unit, and it is the last lesson of our week for science. So we have been talking all about matter. We talked about the properties of matter, so color, texture, size, and shape. We talked about the three states of matter, solid, liquid, gas. Yesterday we talked about physical and chemical changes. So today we're going to be talking a little bit more about water and the different states of matter that water can be in at different times. Okay, so today is day four, and as I said before, we're going to be talking about the different states of water. Now, I know a couple days ago we talked about how water is a liquid, right? How it doesn't have a shape, but water also comes as a solid and a gas. The water we drink is a liquid. So this water that we are drinking, that's a liquid. But when water is frozen, it becomes ice. It becomes a solid. See, it has a shape. All the molecules are very close together. It's a solid. Water in the form of gas is water vapor. So this right here is called water vapor. This is water that is turning into a gas. Taking away or adding heat can change water. Think about making ice. All right, well, let's think about when we make ice. When I make ice in my kitchen, I have a little ice cube tray. And I go over to the sink and I fill it up with water. It's regular liquid water. And then I put it inside the freezer. So I'm taking away any heat. I'm freezing it. If I were to wait a couple hours, the water inside my ice trays would be frozen. They would be ice cubes, which means they would be a solid. But if I were to take out my ice tray and leave it on my kitchen table for a few more hours, it would melt. It would turn back into a liquid. See, that's why that is a physical change, just like what we learned about yesterday. So this little girl right here is eating a popsicle. This popsicle is a solid. It's frozen. But if I were to leave it out in the sun, it's going to melt into a liquid. So now we know what happens if we take away heat from water. It turns into an ice cube. It freezes. But let's see what happens when we add heat to water. Adding heat can change water. Look at the water in the pot. How does the water change as the stove heats it? Okay, well, let's see. This is kind of like what we talked about the other day with our physical changes. First, we put the water in the pot and we turn the stove on. Well, it's starting to boil, see? It's getting very, very hot. And if you look right here, there's steam coming out of it. The steam is called water vapor. So the water turns into water vapor. It evaporates into the air. Evaporation is the change of water from a liquid to a gas. Okay, so let's look down here at this lake. This lake is full of water. And what happens is when the hot sun beats down on the lake, the water begins to get warm. And what it does is it starts to turn into a gas. It starts to evaporate and go into the air. Sometimes you can see it as steam or as fog, and that's what's happening right now. The water is turning into a water vapor. It's going into the air as a gas. Right here, somebody put the water on the stove and they started boiling it. And since it's so hot, since you are adding heat, the water is turning into a gas. It's beginning to evaporate and turn into water vapor. But it doesn't stay a gas forever. Eventually, it does turn back to water. And that's through a process called condensation. So how does water vapor change back into water? Just take away heat. So you know that in order for evaporation to happen, you need to add heat. Well, for condensation, to turn the water vapor back to water, you need to take away heat. So let's look at this window. This window is very cold. So let's look at this window. When somebody took this picture, it was probably in the middle of winter and the window was very cold. What happens is when the air hits this cold window, the water vapor that is inside the air begins to change back into water. And that's because you are taking away heat. You're making it cold, so it is turning back into water. So condensation is the change from water as a gas to a liquid. Here's another example. So the students who are in my class know that I love to drink iced coffee. I love to go to Hagu Shop right next to school. I like to go get a Thai iced espresso. It's one of my favorite drinks in Thailand. But every time I go and buy it, something happens to my cup. When I first get my coffee, it's totally normal. There's nothing wrong with my cup. But as soon as I walk outside, something happens to my cup. Water begins to form on the outside of my coffee cup. And it's not because coffee is leaking. It's water. Water is leaking. And this is because of condensation. See, my coffee is cold. It's iced Thai espresso. So when the warm, moist air touches my cup, condensation happens. The water vapor in the air begins to turn back into water. And that is why sometimes when you have a cold drink outside, there might be water on the outside of your cup. Now you know a little bit more about the three states of water. We know that water can come in the form of a solid, so ice cubes. It can come in the form of a liquid. And water can come in the form of a gas. Okay, all right. So you can go ahead and go back to Seesaw and finish your activity for the day. Bye!